Hello everyone, welcome back to Neural Network Lectures. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about how to implement various logic gates using Matulovich model. Before going on to that, I hope that everyone is familiar with the nonlinear model of neural. So let us take a quick glance to it. Okay. So this is the nonlinear model of neuron where we have the input nodes over here, that is x1, x2, etc. to xn. Then we have w11, w12, w13. I hope that everyone is familiar with the notations. Then we have a linear summarizer Vk, which is given by Vk equal to sigma j equal to 1 to n xj wkj. And this Vk goes into an activation function and we get yk equal to phi of Vk. Okay. Now, this model will become a Matulovich model where we give a bias to it. Let bias be theta k. So, this Vk ultimately becomes Vk equal to j equal to 1 to n xj wkj plus theta k, right? Therefore, the output will be yk equal to phi of this vk, that is sigma j equal to 1 to n xj wkj plus theta k, okay? And instead of giving the theta k over here, I can give it as an input, right? I will give another source node and set its input as x0 equal to 1. Then I will join it to here. Then I will give the weight over here as theta k. Okay. Then another condition for this to be a Matulovich model is that the activation function should be threshold function. That is, phi of vk should be 1 when vk greater than or equal to 0 and 0 when vk less than 0. I hope that everyone is familiar with this. Now we will try to implement the logic AND gate. Okay. So first we need to draw the truth table for AND gate. That is A, B, Y, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And the outputs are 0, 0, 0, 1. Right. So we know that Vk equal to sigma xj wkj plus theta k. Right. That's j equal to 1 to n. But in this particular case, we have only two inputs. So this n equal to 2. This becomes x1w11 plus x2w12 plus theta 1. Okay. And we also have only one output neuron. Therefore, k equal to 1. And this is x1, this is x2, and this is y1. According to threshold function, we know that phi of vk, that is yk, will be 1. When vk is greater than 0 and 0, sorry, greater than or equal to 0 and 0 when vk less than 0. So, what we need to do is, we need to adjust the bias theta 1 in such a way that only in this case, vk will be greater than 0 or equal to 0. In all these cases, vk should be less than 0. So, let us try to implement that. So, let us take this row, that is row 1. Before that, let us for initialization take w11 equal to 1, w12 equal to 1 and theta k equal to minus 1. Sorry, theta 1 equal to minus 1. This is random assumption and you can take whatever values you like. Okay. But it will be easier if we take w11 equal to 1, w12 equal to 1 and theta we will see. Okay. And now we can see v1 equal to x1, that is 0 in this case. Okay. In this rows. 0 into 1 plus x2, that is 0 into 1 plus theta k, that is 1, and this is equal to 1, which is greater than 0. Therefore, we got v1 greater than 0, which means output will be 1, but we need the output to be 0. Therefore, we need to update the value of theta 1. Therefore, let us take theta 1 equal to minus 1 now. So, v1 will be in similar fashion 0 into 1 plus 0 into 1 plus minus 1. So this is equal to minus 1 and less than 0. Therefore, v1 less than 0 and we got the output as y equal to 0. So our condition is satisfied for the first row. Now we need to check for the second row. Therefore, row 2. The inputs are x1 equal to 0 into 1 plus, this is bias, okay, 1. And the x2 is equal to 1. Therefore, 1 into w12, that is 1. And the value of bias is currently is minus 1. Okay, therefore minus 1. And we'll get it as 0. And we know that when V1 is greater than or equal to 0, we have the output to be 1. But we need the output to be 0. Therefore, let us update the bias to be theta 1 equal to minus 1.5. Okay. And let us write V1 again. V1 equal to 0 into 1 plus 1 into 1 minus 1.5, which is minus 0.5. Therefore, in this case, V1 is less than 0 and we get y equal to 0. Hence, it is satisfied for row 2. Now, check again for row 1. You will find that row 1 will become now V1 equal to minus 1.5. Thus, this bias is satisfied for row 1 and row 2. Now, we should go to row 3. Okay, that is this case. So, for row 3, V1 equal to, what is the input? X1 is 1 and X2 is 0. Okay, 1 into 1 plus 0 into 1 minus the current bias is 1.5, right? And we will get it as minus 0.5. Therefore, V1 is less than 0 implies YK is or Y1 is equal to 0. And that is the output we needed. Okay, so we don't need to update the bias. Now, let us check for row 4. And here we know that X1 equal to 1 and X2 equal to 1. Therefore, V1 equal to 1 into 1 plus 1 into 1 minus 1.5, which we get as 0.5. And V1 is greater than or equal to 0 implies Y1 equal to 1. Therefore, if we check, we can see that for row 1, we got the output as 0. For row 2, we got the output as 0. Row 3, we got the output as 0. And row 4, we got the output as 1. So, this was the condition we needed to implement the logic OR gate, right? So, we can write the equation finally as Vk equal to x1 into 1 plus x2 into 1 minus 1.5. Now, if we draw the Maculopics model for this, we have x0 equal to 1, x1 and x2. Then we have the linear summarizer over here. And this is Vk equal to minus 1.5. And this is W11 equal to 1. And this is W12 equal to 1. And here there is V1. This goes to the activation function phi of V1. And we get the output. So this is the AND gate implementation using Maculopics model. Now we will see for the OR gate. Proceeding in the similar fashion, first we need to write the truth table. Okay. So A, B, Y, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And this will be 0, 1, 1, 1. Now write Vk equal to x1 into W11 plus x2 into W12 plus theta k. Okay. And let us assume W11 equal to 1. W12 equal to 1 and theta k equal to 1. Now, taking for row 1, Vk equal to 0 into 1 plus 0 into 1 plus 1 equal to 1. Therefore, we can see that Vk is greater than or equal to 0 implies yk equal to 1. But we need the yk to be 0. So, let us update the bias theta k to minus 1. Now, Vk will be 0 into 1 plus 0 into 1 plus minus 1, which gives us minus 1, implies Vk is less than 0, implies Yk equal to 0. Therefore, for the first row, we have cleared. Now, moving on to second row, row 2, Vk is equal to 0 into 1 plus 1 into 1 plus minus 1, which gives us 0. And we know that for Vk greater than or equal to 0, Yk is 1. Therefore, for the second row also, it is clear. Now, we will move on to the third row. Okay. Row 3. V1 equal to 1 into 1 plus 0 into 1 minus 1, which is 0. And we know that Vk greater than or equal to 0, Yk equal to 1. And the required output was also 1. So, it is cleared for row 3 also. Now, we will check into row 4. And V1 is 1 into 1 plus 1 into 1 minus 1. Which is 1. And we know that for Vk greater than or equal to 0, we have Yk equal to 1. Therefore, the outputs are, for row 1, it is 0, row 2, it is 1, row 3, it is 1, row 4, it is 1. Thus, we have implemented the OR gate, right? So, now drawing the Michaelovitz model, we have three input nodes. This is x2, this is x1, and this is x0 equal to 1. And there's a linear summarizer. We have the bias dk equal to minus 1. This is w11 equal to 1, w12 equal to 1, and this is vk. There's an activation function phi of vk, and there is output. Okay. Now we'll try to implement the Michaelovitz model for NOT gate. Okay. Here also, as usual, we'll draw the truth table first. It is x, y, 0, 1, 1, 0. Right? And this will be x1 and this will be y1. Since here is only one output, our v1 will be x1 into w11 plus theta k. Okay. And now to initialize for row 1, let us take w11 equal to 1 and theta k equal to minus 1. Okay. Now for row 1, we have v1 equal to 0 into 1 minus 1 equal to minus 1, which is less than 0. Therefore, our output y1 will be 0. But we need the output to be 1. Therefore, let us update the theta k to plus 1. Now, v1 equal to 0 into 1 plus 1 equal to 1, which is greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, our output will be y1. Therefore, the condition is satisfied for row 1. Now, let's take row 2. And v1 equal to 1 into 1 plus 1, which is 2, which is greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, output will be 1. But we need the output to be 0. Now we have already tried the negative value for theta k, that is minus 1, right? So it is not necessary that we should change theta k only. We can change w11 also. So let us try with the w11 equal to minus 1. Therefore, v1 equal to 1 into minus 1 plus 1, which is equal to 0. Here still the output will be y1 equal to 1. Therefore, let us try updating the theta k again, okay? So let us let theta k equal to 0.5. Therefore, our output for second row will become 1 into minus 1, which is w11, okay, plus 0.5, which is minus 0.5, which is less than 0. Therefore, our output will be y1 equal to 0 as needed. Okay. Now let us cross check this again for row 1. For row 1, v1 equal to 0 into minus 1 plus 0.5, which is equal to 0.5, greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, y1 equal to 1. Thus, for row 1, we have output as 1, and row 2, we have output as 0. This was what is required, right? See, here also 1 into 0. Therefore, we have implemented the NOT gate as vk equal to minus 1 x1 plus 0.5. See, this is just one of the possible combinations. You can actually find many possible combinations. It's up to you. Okay. This is just what I did here. Therefore, according to this, let us draw the Michaelovitz model. And there is two input nodes. Then this is x1. This is the bias. And bias is equal to 0.5. There is the linear summarizer. And w11 is equal to minus 1. It is the activation function. Then here is the output. Okay. Now let us try to implement a NOR gate using Michaelovitz model. Okay. And let us draw the truth table first. A, B, Y, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Right. And the outputs are 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay. And let this be x1, let this be x2, and let this be y1. Therefore, v1 equal to x1 w11 plus x2 w12 plus theta k. Okay, let us take actually it's theta 1. Let us take w11 equal to 1, w12 equal to 1, and theta 1 equal to minus 1. Okay, this is a random assumption. For row 1, v1 will be given as 0 into 1 plus 0 into 1 plus minus 1, which is minus 1. And which is less than or equal to 0. Therefore, yk will be 0. We need the output to be 1. Therefore, let us update theta 1 to 1. Now V1 will be 0 into 1 plus 0 into 1 plus 1 equal to 1, which is greater than or equal to 0. So here there is only less than 0. Okay. Therefore, yk equal to 1. Therefore, the condition for row 1 is satisfied. Now, let us check for row 2. Okay. V1 equal to 0 into 1 plus 1 into 1 plus 1, which is equal to 2, which is greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, yk equal to 1. But we need the yk to be 0, right? So, let us try to change w1 and w1 to here, okay? So, let w11 equal to minus 1 and w12 equal to minus 1. These are random assumptions. You can take whatever value you like, okay? And just try to enforce this condition, that is, v1 greater than or equal to 0, okay? Therefore, here, according to our w11 and w12, v1 will be 0 into minus 1 plus 1 into minus 1 plus 1, which is 0, which is still greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, yk equal to 1. Okay, so this doesn't work either. So let us try to update theta 1 to 0.5. Therefore, v1 will now become v1 equal to 0 into minus 1 plus 1 into minus 1 plus 0.5. We'll get it as minus 0.5, which is less than 0. Therefore, yk will be 0. Therefore, our condition for row 2 is also satisfied. Let us check for row 3. V1 will be 1 into minus 1 plus 0 into minus 1 plus 0.5, which is also minus 0.5 less than 0. Therefore, yk is equal to 0. Thus, the condition is satisfied for row 3 also. Now, let us check for row 4. This is V1 equal to 1 into minus 1 plus 1 into minus 1 plus 0.5, which is equal to minus 1.5, which is also less than 0. Therefore, yk equal to 0 is satisfied. Our last condition also, right? Therefore, we can write v1 equal to x1 into minus 1 plus x2 into minus 1 plus 0.5. Using this, we can implement the Michaelovich model as three input nodes. Okay, x0 equal to 1. So there's a linear summarizer. So this is bias theta k equal to 0.5. This is w11 equal to minus 1. This is x1, this is x2. This is w12 equal to minus 1. And this is v1 going to an activation function phi of k of v1 equal to 0.5. Thus, we have successfully implemented the NOR gate also. Now, in similar fashion, you can implement the NAND gate also. You can try that as a homework as you know the methodology, right? And in the next lecture, we will try to implement the XOR and XNOR gates and also the implementation of logic AND and OR gate using Hebbian principle. Okay, so that's all for today's lecture. Thank you for watching and have a good day.